Welcome back to Politics What. This is Serpy. Now today I'm going to talk about a couple of stories. One is going to be the fine in Montego Bay, right, the rifle them with them fine. A whole heap of money. Right. We're talking about $1 million. We're going to look into it. But that isn't even going to be the center of my argument. I'm going to put the argument bigger than even the rifle them, because there's a piece of equipment on the table that catch my eye even more than the rifle. I'm also going to briefly touch on incident that took place in Olympic Way, right, where about 8 people or so and I'm get shot to lose them life. But before I go any further, I want to send a special happy anniversary to Patreon squad members Akeem and Kira. Right, they're celebrating their 4th wedding anniversary, right, so 4 years down, 400 more to go. Right, big up on yourself. Well, hope you have a great day. Despite all the madness we're going to the Big C, but I hope you guys can celebrate properly and make it a day to remember. It's always a beautiful sight when two becomes one. Now, we can move into the video. Montego Bay, the real Hollywood, never cease to amaze us. Reports are that security forces will hang by 8 people, including a female, after they found 2 AK-47 rifles, 1 AR-15 rifle, 4 Glock magazines, 2 of which are extended, 21 7.62 rounds, 21 5.56 rounds, 33 9mm rounds. You have to talk about over $1 million. You gone well over $1 million. Right there, sir. Just in a firepower alone. Look on the AK, camo, even the magazine, it's camo. I wonder if you realize how much money they need to run up and down. How much money, how much millions stash off, hide off, underground, in a corner, tuck away, in a bush, wrap up in a sheet. Millions of dollars. But what really stand out to me is not even the camo AK. Right. It's not even the AR. But it's the police hat on the table. Got them find that too. Why is that a big deal? Me not understand. You have 3 rifles on a table, much extended magazine, much round Yanlupar hat. Yes, it's important, because I get to realize it is simply too easy for criminals to get a hold of uniform and equipment that belong to the security forces. It's a major deal, because if you drive down the road one night and you see somebody step out in the road, couple of men step out in the road in full denim, and you see them with police hat on them head, AR-15 / M16 type rifle in them hand, and them point and they pull over, yeah, pull over, cause as far as you can turn a police. And then when you pull over, well, probably won't end too well for you. So how the people not gonna know who is who? Remember the 87 named Billie Jean? Him did have the vest, the hat, right? The blue denim are the easiest thing to get, right? That is the easiest thing to get. So when them get the vest and the hat, right? Again, the boots on them foot easy to get. And them have the same rifle, right? The average civilian can't tell difference between the M16, the M4 and the AR. Them all are not the same, the average person. Right? Especially the one them at this length. So, people are pulled over. They want officer, and you send the officer. This is a major deal. It's not somewhere, oh, I just want a hat. No, it's not just one hat. Oh, I just want, we are going to have one little vest. It's not just a vest. It gives criminals the ability, right, to load their victims into a trap even easier. And it's ironic, this come out now shortly after we see there's a video that was circulating on some of the social media pages. I have a screenshot right of it. It's up on your screen right now. This was from a video of a brother wearing on the police vest, as you can see, and even the police helmet, right, with the biker police them have. And him walk out on the road and him direct traffic, him pint the car of them, right, for go over a certain part. Everything in Jamaica is a joke, but why I'm telling you why that's not funny? Because you see, in this instance, him have on one t-shirt and one jeans. But let's say him did have on one blue denim. And you see police helmet, pan head. You see police vest, blue denim. When you're looking at man, you see one M16, when you look, you see him have on boots pan his foot. And a three of them, all of them are the same thing. And them pints, if you pull over, you think sir, a traffic stop. You think that you will get your documents ready. You will get your registration and you will get your license. And you then turn that 87. So you hand your license to 87. Remember say your address there on 87, you know. One of people, sorry, one of remember say your address there on your license, you know. On 87. Alright. Dress up like police. I'll look on or just say you live. Alright, cool. This is serious business. The security forces need to get whatever punishment is in place need to get increased. Right. Whether them are learn it, they can or me can't find it, you better go find it. Right. I know that there are procedures in place for doing it, but most of the times they're not enforced. This is not a joke thing. 87s are built entire uniform or them are pick piece of scraps. Now we have the hat, now we have the vest. The blue denim is fine already. Where the boots is fine. We already have the AR-15. Alright, now we can touch the road. You know what people did like? This was one of the main ways Stone Crusher used to take out people. Right, bigger crime them. Trevor, what them for them strategy was to dress up like police. And when them step out on the road and pint somebody will come over, people are pull over. That's what you do, you pull over when police stop you. Oh, you're gonna stand the police. They ain't know nobody. You don't see uniform. There's a reason why when you go in our hospital, you see doctors have a uniform, nurse have a uniform. Everybody have a, that way, if you need a doctor, you walk to the man. If you need a nurse, you walk to that person. If you need the porter, you walk to that person. It's to identify people. Right? Or if you walk around in a doctor clothes and then you're gonna run to your doc, you can't do this, and you're gonna tell me, so, oh, you know, say me, I know a doctor, I'm just have on the jacket and everything because I like the style. You know, hospital tell people, I just like the swagger. But I'm not a doctor. Nothing can go, so them that run you out, take off that. You can't have that on because you're going to make people run to you for help and you can't help them. Right? Now imagine when it's more sinister, like a 87, just like a police. It's nothing to take lightly. And the next thing JCF needs to consider is that. It's disastrous from a PR point of view because that means say 3487 can go on for them apps, go wake up people, 4 or 5 people, right, lay them out flat on the ground, and then as far as the average civilian is concerned, a 4 police come kill somebody. Because I'm a police traveling an unmarked car too. So it's not like say you can say, well, oh, them never have no police car, that I mean no police traveling an unmarked car. So them say 4 man pull up, full denim, right, man have on vest, everything, kill a man and gone. People are gonna say JCF just come kill a man. So it's in JCF best interest for step up the enforcement of the rules they have now or make it even stricter. It's not common to see people in a JDF uniform, but I'm sure them they're out there in the streets too. I'm sure man have them too, because especially the older uniform, maybe a man in the middle of them enough. You see, because maybe 87s, one thing with them, because them have the money. Right? Them tend to have a style if you just buy them way into certain things. See, they may buy the uniform off a policeman, but I ain't gonna tell them, say, oh, you know, some last my vest. Right? 87s, they have their money, right? Then buy this and then buy that and build the uniform piece by piece. The police them who sell it to them, no say, oh, them just fill out on little farm and not really a lot to them. especially the major things like vest. If man I go tell you say him lose vest and he can't find this one, people have to go learn. It's not a joke thing. Anyway, let me move on to Olympic way briefly. Now, party going. People, I'm not even going to talk about the fact that the party are going through Big C because enough people in the business about that again. I've been telling you enough, as far as enough people concerned, Big C might not even happen. They do what they want to do. Right, so, people are come from party, probably just to enjoy themselves. But look who's coming. Mr. Death and Destruction. According to Luke, about 8 people that get shot, 2 of them lose them life. Man, go by the name of Bugman, next one by the name of Bums. Man. I see a video with that woman. I don't know what relationship she have to the man, but Pierre Bali and my next man in the background, Pantapa Theme Voice. You see, when I tell them, they say, crime and violence is nothing entertaining, and people don't realize that till they reach them doorstep. Videos like that show you what's going on. Obviously, I can't show the video. I'm actually going to put that on Patreon and do a second video on it because more people see what I talk about. Right, but when you hear a woman and a ball and man lie down in the street and she hug him up on a ball and he bridging the panther, crime and violence is ugly. Very ugly. Kiara Pass, one time Miss Sue said the vehicle I go look down, man. What she does at that point, she not care because she's so caught up on the fact that the youth they don't spread up on the ground. That's all see, I see. Right. 8 people. Cause more than likely I just them 2 man the 87s them come find them, but you know 87s are ready. Especially in a crowd setting. You know for them shot them flying on all about the place. One news report say 5 plus the 2 loops say 8 total, so somewhere around that figure, but you know 87s. You know want them nowhere near when them are come. So in the blink of an eye, people went from joy and laughter, right, to death and destruction and misery. Right? And now 9 night a plan, set up a plan, funeral a plan. Just like that, didn't take much. 1 minute, you just go on illegal Big C rave. Enjoy yourself. On your way home. You probably make plans for the next day. Or you know, so tomorrow I'm going to pick up this. Alright. Yo, you know, so many for links want to choose and pick up. You have make big plan. And you know, so you won't see the next day. You have plan for Friday and you won't even see Tuesday. So fast life happen. Anyway, I'm gonna finish up this part of the video on Patreon because we need to show the video clip them for people really so hard one, but it don't know 2 grams for YouTube. So Patreon squad, look out for that video in about half an hour time. PIA, you don't know, more life. Ultra squad, stay circling. Bless.